This painting is titled Two Dogs on a Dead End Road. I painted it kind of in a sort of a diptych with the lightning bug lantern hat. Did them at the same time. Inspired by the same road, really. A road that, I drove down it a lot when I was younger. My granddad bought a house at the end of this road called the Roten House. It had been abandoned for a number of years. And I had to help him clean it out and kind of renovate it. And then he turned it into the family lake house home towards the end of his life. The road was long, it was gravel. At one point there had been an old mansion down the road that an African-American fella had lived in, and it burnt down to the ground. People believed he was still out there. They'd see him out there in the field on a white horse, probably looking for his house. But I was down there one day walking my dog, and I'd always heard stories of packs of wild dogs out there on the country, well, anywhere in the South, but this was South Carolina. And, you don't want to get out there unless you have a gun. If a pack of dogs get after you, they're going to rip you apart. And in fact, that actually happened here not long ago here in Georgia, out towards, Crawford, somewhere out there. Happened in the past 10 years, probably around 2011, sometime around in then. An old couple were out and a pack of dogs got after him, and I think he killed both of them. No, killed one of them. But I was down there on Roten Road walking a dog, and I heard a pack of them out there in the woods. They were coming towards us, and my dog was named Bubby. I looked down and I said, "All right, Bubby, we got to get booking." And we turned around and the dog knew. Dog knew we had to get out of there. And I ran as fast as I could back to the house through the gates. We made it. And I don't know if anybody ever went down there to get these dogs. You know, you don't know if they're wild, so. And they get after your livestock and all that, so you got to shoot them. Oh, no. I don't know if anybody ever did that. I never did. I knew there were a couple other instances. There was an old barn back up there in the woods, and there were some wild puppies shacked up in there. You couldn't get them to come to you. And then there was another time. There was a cat with rabies that got after me. Didn't get me or anything, but it was in this bush, just... It's scary. It's just like evil looking. And then a few days later, it was curled up by the steps at the Roten House. And you could tell it couldn't walk anymore, but it still had that evil on its face. And my granddad said, "Oh, you got to shoot it in the head." And I didn't want to shoot it. I mean, I hunted and everything. I just didn't want to shoot this cat in the head. And he got all put out with me, and he took care of it. Then he got his farmhand Eddie to go throw it off in the woods. But when I did this painting, I was thinking about that road, and I think I'm going to go back out there and shoot some video of that road. The house is gone. Last time I looked, it was leveled. It was right on the lake, Lake Greenwood, and beautiful old home, but it's gone. I don't think there's anything out there now. But a spooky road. I used to take some friends out there at night. We'd sleep out there. And I remember one time a couple of them were leaving, going down this road, and a naked man just came running out of the woods screaming and hollering. This is out in the middle of nowhere. We don't know if he was a wild man, a feral human, or just some drunk guy lost out in the woods. But I didn't see him, but I'm sure it happened. Because that kind of weird stuff happens out there in upstate South Carolina. I won't even start talking about the lizard man. But this painting is a 24 by 24 on wood. And Georgia red mud painting. And again, it's part of a kind of a diptych with the lightning bug haint, which I'm going to talk about here in another video. And that's about it with this one. Let me know if you have any questions about it. Thanks for listening.